We're just 3 days away from 2021, but a lot has happened in the week before the new year. The House voted to override President Trump's veto on the National Defense Authorization Act. The man responsible for the Nashville RV bombing on Christmas Day has been identified, and COVID-19 vaccinations are being administered by the millions. I'm Joe Moronsky, and this is What's Happening. The annual Military Policy Bill, or the National Defense Authorization Act, was passed and sent to President Trump's desk on December 11th, 2020. Yesterday, December 28th, the House voted to override President Trump's veto from November 23rd, with a 322-87 vote. This is the first veto which the House has voted to override since the beginning of President Trump's term in 2016. The bill had bipartisan support during its original vote, with only 79 members of the House not voting to pass it, and only 13 members of the Senate voting against it. This $740 billion bill sets policies regarding every aspect of the military, including restrictions to how President Trump can move money to be used on the border wall construction, a strict layout of procedures for removing troops from Germany and Afghanistan, and provided a raise to troops around the world. President Trump was upset due to the fact that the bill did not include a repeal of Section 230, a Communications Act which states that private companies such as Twitter and Facebook can't be held liable for what its users post on its website. On Christmas Day, Anthony Quinn Warner, a 63-year-old man from the Nashville area, drove his RV onto 2nd Avenue North in downtown Nashville. An eerie recording would play for about 15 minutes, warning of a bomb inside the vehicle, which would soon explode. As officers scrambled to evacuate nearby buildings, the RV delivered on the ominous promise, causing devastation to buildings, business owners, and residents of 2nd Avenue North. The explosion caused regional outages after impacting a nearby AT&T transmission facility and resulted in an ongoing closure of roads. Police and the FBI confirmed that Warner's remains were identified as the remains found inside the RV after the explosion. Although no motive has been uncovered yet, neighbors of Warner have told journalists from across the country about his unusual behavior. One neighbor told CNN that after he asked Warner if he was going to get anything good for Christmas, Warner responded, quote, "Yes, I'm going to be more famous. I'm going to be so famous, Nashville will never forget me." End quote. The investigation is still ongoing, but investigators have stated they have no reason to believe more bombs are out there or that Warner was working with an accomplice. COVID-19 vaccinations are being administered by millions. According to the CDC, as of December 28th, over 11 million doses have been delivered and over 2 million people have received the first round of the vaccine. Both the Pfizer and the Moderna vaccines, the only two who have been granted emergency use approval by the FDA, require two doses and to be stored at low temperatures. So far, no deaths have been reported in connection with the COVID-19 vaccine, although numerous allergic reactions have been reported across the country. In addition to the reactions, 7 cases of Bell's palsy, a temporary facial paralysis, was reported in trial participants. However, after further investigation, this number is in line with the average percent of people diagnosed with Bell's palsy each day. And as small businesses struggle nationwide due to the COVID-19 pandemic, an unexpected person has stepped in to help. Dave Portnoy, also known as Stool Presidente, is the president of Barstool Sports. Known for his crazy antics and pizza reviews, Portnoy has stepped in and created the Barstool Fund to help struggling businesses. So far, the fund has raised almost $9 million and helped businesses across the nation. The fund is designed to help these businesses month to month by helping with finances until the pandemic ends. This is just another example that sometimes the least expected person can make the most impact. I'm Joe Moronsky, and that's What's Happening.